Okay, first, open the file, in file, import. And I choose this. And okay, okay. I scale it down, so click the image and hold Control Shift to create a proportional scale around this. You can make the photo fit automatically to the page. So by pressing Shift Control R. So the page or the canvas automatically same size as the photo. We're on the layer tabs. So you can create new layer, this icon, and I made vector. This is for the photo. You can lock this photo layer. So we were on this vector layer with Bezier tool. Zoom in and press B to activate the Bezier tool. So in this case, we do manually with the Bezier tool. So you can click and drag. And on here, just click. Next, we were on the hair. So just follow the shape of the hair. You can place the node in here. Just click and drag on here. A tip for you to lock the corners. So I'm just click and drag like before. And you can hold shift to lock the corner. So it will lock this one handle and free this another handle. And just release this shift. Continue. On here, you can lock again the corner. After you click and drag, hold shift. And this one handle, I move to here and release. Okay, continue. And on the edge, you can click and drag again. Then hold shift to lock the corner. Make it 90 degrees, then release. On here, I'm locking the corner again. This is good practice with Bezier tool. If you want to master the Bezier tool, once you've understand to use the Bezier tool, you can almost create anything with it. The Bezier tool gives you more flexibility to draw. Turn off this photo layer to see the result. Change this line into fill. So on the left corner, right click, choose sort fill and stroke. There you go. Or you can create this silhouette with Inkscape. So let me show you one more how to create a silhouette with GIMP. Open my GIMP. You can see I select it with the advanced selection. I put a link on description how to create this advanced selection and GIMP. Or let's say you use the background remover online. Here's the next steps to do in GIMP. After it become this PNG or the selections, right click, output to selection, then go to edit, just fill it foreground color because all foreground color in this black color or any color that you like. Then deselect it in select, choose none. That's how you can create the silhouette in GIMP. But if I'm zoom in, this pixelated because it's the bitmap. And how to convert it become a vector? So you get the high quality result by going to file, export. Make sure you choose the PNG or you can type the PNG. Click export. Just click export. Now let's open up in Inkscape and you can go to file, import, choose the exported image and click OK. Scale it down, holding Control Shift. Create a proportional scale. And let's see if I zoom in, it's still like pixelated. Convert it to vector by going to path, choose trace bitmap. Can adjust the setting, but I just leave it by default. Click apply. Here's the result. If I zoom in from the second, it will become a vector. You can press F2. To see the notes. After you convert it to vector, you can change to any color, same like this. This is the high quality. Can make it larger without losing the quality. Press F2. So you see the result. If you convert from bitmap to vector, you will get these many nodes. But it's your choice, that's up to you. You can use with the Bezier tool method, or you can remove the background in game or with background remover application. Okay, I'm going to create the new page, so click this icon. Create and edit document page. And you can add the page. Let's give some color, a circle, hold Ctrl Shift. Place it in the back and give some background with black color. So click this rectangle tool. Make sure you turn on this enable snapping to make it auto fit when you drag the rectangle. Press F1 and send it to the lower back. And change the color to this black. Press T, take the Drupal tool and click this color. Alright. Can scale it down. So here's the two results. This is from the Bezier tool that I draw manually, and this is from GIMP to convert it into a vector. Okay, that's all. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.